Yesterday we were doing question answer. We were discussing question answers. So we will continue with the same topic. So first question and second question, both these questions were discussed yesterday. So let's proceed to question number third. I looked into the mirror and smiled. This dialogue was spoken by a homeopathic doctor. A little later, he says, I forgot my danger and smiled feebly at myself. What is the doctor's opinion about himself when he first smiles and he smiles again? See, when he was looking into the mirror, too, he smiled first. So, but both the circumstances and both the situations were quite different. What was that first situation when he was looking into the mirror? At that time, he was absolutely free and he was appreciating his beauty. He wants to improve his looks. Okay, and what was the second circumstance? What was the second situation when snake coiled around his neck? At that time, he was feeling so humble. Okay, so these are the differences between these two situations. So, who is going to elaborate this answer in detail? Get ready for that. I can ask any of the child. Dhiren, you keep your video on. Arzu, Aparan, all of you keep your video on. Yes, Dhiren, what do you want to say?
And I want to answer.
Yes, you answer.
Yes, ma'am. I'm at first time when the doctor was smiling, so he was free and he was not able to sleep because of the heat and the rats, sound of rats. So he started looking himself into the mirror. As he was unmarried and was a bachelor, he started appreciating himself and his beauty. But at second time when he was smiling, it was when the snake has coiled around him. He was smiling on his stupidity and foolishness at how snake has wrapped around him and his one arm has fainted.
Okay, good. Now, Aparan, you tell me this answer. Same answer. Yes, Aparan.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Tell me this answer. Aparan, I'm waiting for your answer. Hurry up. Tell me answer. You unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am. When the doctor was looking himself in the mirror, he was great admirer of his beauty. And as he was bachelor, he was deciding to get married as he was doctor also and handsome also. Second time he was very much...
Second time his situation was different, he was feeling helpless because there was a snake around his neck. Aparan, I didn't expect it from you. Simran.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Simran. Tell me. See, both the situations are different. Why both the situations are different? Because in first situation, he was smiling. He was just appreciating his youthful beauty. Why so? Because he is bachelor. he is a bachelor. He wants to focus on its beauty. He wanted to improve his looks. So this was the first situation. So what was that situation? That situation was that when snake was near to him and he was smiling at his situation, that now what to do? How to escape himself from such kind of situation? Yes, Renuka, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, in first situation, the doctor was smiling by as he was appreciating his beauty by looking in the mirror. But the second time, he was smiling on his foolishness that the snake was hanging on his.
Now all of you should have books in your hand. I'm going to call any of the child to keep their camera on. If you're not able to keep their camera on, no problem, you reply me your answer. And those who are not able to speak even a single line, I'm going to mark them absent. Then your class will be on track because you are not paying any heed towards the content, what is going in the class. Because I don't want that you should become passive listener. You should be active in class. You should participate. Whether you speak wrong or right, try to speak the answer. I am here to help you. Then what is right line and what is wrong line? Okay, Jayati, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. When the first time the doctor looked him into the mirror, he was smiling at his beauty. He was appreciating himself as he was a bachelor and was making a decision to get married. But when second time he looked in the mirror, he was smiling at his stupidity. He was feeling helpless as he had no medicines at his home and the death was just 4 inches away from him. He was feeling so helpless and wanted to just escape from the snake.
Good, very good, perfect. Okay, now same answer. Now Jayati, you are marked present because those who are responding in my class, I'm only giving them, I'm writing present for them, otherwise they will be marked absent if they are not able to tell me the answer. Now Jashan, you tell me this answer. Yes, Jashan. Jashan, I'm waiting for your answer. Jashan, tell me this answer. Now, Jashan, you are marked absent if you are not able to give the answer. I am giving you permission to unmute yourself still if you are not able to unmute. So, what is the problem? Pranay, keep the camera on. Then I will give you a chance to speak. Yes, Jashan, unmute yourself and tell me this answer. Jashan, you are marked absent. You don't know this answer. Okay, Nitya. Nitya, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Can you repeat one more?
Same answer. That what for both situations? You don't have book in front of you, with you?
No, ma'am. I actually I don't have the latest version of the book, so I don't know which question you're talking about.
Without book, how will you answer? I'm so surprised. Without book, how are you studying? Now tell me. Question is right in front of you.
the doctor looks into the mirror and smiles because
really bad. Just leave the first line, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. When the doctor looks into the mirror, he firstly smiled due to his youthful beauty, and he then again looked into the mirror and smiled on his stupidity, and he was helpless that time. His thoughts got changed due to the encounter with this snake.
Okay, clear. Now let's move to next question. Get ready with your next answer. Next question we have that this story about a frightening incident is narrated in a humorous way. See, it is really a frightening incident. Suppose in your room any snake comes, so anybody, like if I'm there, if you are there, anybody can be frightened, okay? But narrator has described this story in a very funny way, in a very humorous way, hilarious way, okay? So you have to make a contrast in present between dreams and reality, okay? The kind of person the doctor is and the kind of person he wants to be. So the kind of person the doctor is, you have to tell both kind of, and both kind of contrast can be depicted using a between dream and reality, between a dream and a reality. So this story is showing a contrast. Why so? Because in this chapter, what is told? See, Dr. Homeopathy doctor, he is living in a very small house in a rented portion. Okay. Wait, I just share the content with you. And all of you jot down the hints, that whatever the hints I'm providing you, just jot down all the hints. Only with the help of these hints, Yug will be giving the answer afterwards. Yug will be the first one. Afterward, I can call any of the child to give me the answer. So your pens should be in your hand. And Nitya, today you are marked absent because you don't have books. Sorry, because without book, you are not able to do
anything. No, I can't get third question.
Their names are also visible. Shall I announce the name? Those who are doing annotation on screen, those who are not responding in class, they are being marked absent. Clear? And those who are coming with fake ID, they will be caught very soon and they will be removed forever from the class. Afterwards, they will not be able to enter. Okay. Now the question is, the kind of person the doctor is, you have to take example of money and possession. You have to tell about the infrastructure of the room, which kind of doctor he was, how much earning he was having, he was rich or poor. All the things are given. I'm providing you hints for that. See, he was on a practice. He was not earning a lot. So that's why he was living in a rented house. And what was the condition of that house? How many clothes he was having? Okay, very less clothes he was having. So from that, all these instances, all these evidence and examples, we are very much clear that the doctor was not having so much possessions, so much money with him. His condition was very poor. Okay, but what he wants to be, what are his ambitions? So these examples you can see when he was looking into the mirror. He wanted to work on his looks, what he wants to achieve in his life, which kind of girl he wants to get married. Okay, so all these examples you can include in this answer. So these are the hints that I have provided to you. Now with the help of these hints, start framing this answer. Get ready. And now this answer I expected from, okay, Yug.
Ma'am, in the given story, the character of the doctor is depicted as the person who doesn't have anything in terms of money and possessions, even though he is in the medical profession, which offers money, power, prestige. The doctor has nothing.
There are so many things you can write in detail, but otherwise you have written 2-3 lines. These are okay, but write down in detail. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Write down all the things in detail. Now, same answer. Jashan, you want to try or shall I mark you absent only? Jashan. Yes, Jashan. You want to give me answer or not? Okay, Arzu, you tell me this answer.
The doctor is a poor man. He does not have much money. His house has no electricity and it is a small rented room which has many rats. He has about 60 rupees in his suitcase and he has very less shirts and dhotis.
So this is the money and possession he is having. So what does he want to become? What are his ambitions? What are his ambitions? What he wants to become? Tell me. I'm providing you so many hints. You just write down all these hints. See, his earning is very less because he has just began his career. I have told you that he was living in a rented house and this house was not even having electricity. He was having very few clothes, very little money. Room was full of rats. But dreams and ambition both have a fully contrast in that. Why so? Because he was considered as an admirer of beauty. He wanted to look handsome. He says that he is a very eligible bachelor and he wants to get married to a doctor. Okay? He decides that he should shave daily. He should have a thin mustache to look more handsome. So the manner in which he takes a decision, it is very much funny. But later on, he decides that he should have a smile on his face. So all these things, all this contrast which is being made, this makes us happy. This makes us feel hilarious. This makes us feel humorous. That how the doctor is living, what is his living style and what does he want to become. So there is a complete contrast, there is a complete comparison between dream and reality. See, he is not able to feel, he is not able to sleep. So what was the option for him? That he starts spending his time to look into the mirror. So as soon as he looks into the mirror, he starts appreciating about his beauty. So what was that? It means there is a huge contrast between his looks and between the reality. Now so much examples are given to you. Now I expect my good students should be ready with their answers. Now I can call any of the child to unmute themselves and tell me the answer. And one thing I want to tell you, if you are not able to tell me the answer, you will be marked absent. Okay, now Divya.
Yes, ma'am. The narrator is a homeopathic doctor and his earnings are meagre. It has been a short while since he began practicing his career. He had very less clothes and uses to live in a rented house, and he is familiar living with rats. But his expectations and dreams are just contrary to reality. He has many possessions. He wants to, as he is a bachelor, he wants to marry a successful and the fat lady doctor who earns more than him. He wants to work on his ambition. As he cannot sleep, he spends his time by looking on the mirror, and his expectations are fully contrast to the reality.
Okay, good. Well tried. Your answer is absolutely correct. You have taken so many points and all points are correct, but try to add some more. Otherwise, content is good. Now, Mitansh.
Yes.
After Mitansh, Laksh Jairath should be ready.
I don't know that.
Yes, speak.
I don't know which.
You don't know which question? Very good. What should I do with such kind of students? See.
Ma'am, I don't know the answer.
You don't know the answer. For last 5 to 10 minutes, I have been telling you the answer. 2-3 students have already told. I have also told you 2-3 times. That you have to make a contrast between dream and a reality. Which kind of person is a homeopathic doctor is, and in future, what does he want to become? What are his ambitions? So you have to make a comparison between both the things. And you don't know what is going. Shall I mark you absent now? Be marked absent. And this video will be uploaded on YouTube. All the videos are uploaded. Other parents, other students will come to know. That is a good thing for you. I'm really happy because all will come to know that you don't know what is going in the class. You are not able to speak even 2 or 3 lines. Tell me. Pranay, you keep your video on, then you ask me your doubt. Mitansh, I was not expecting this thing from you. You really made me disappointed. Now you are marked absent, sorry. You are physically present but not mentally. So the students who are not mentally present in my class, they will be marked absent. So Laksh Jairath, your answer is ready. I'm not telling you to keep your video on. You just tell me answer without keeping your video on. You can tell me the answer. Laksh Jairath. Yes, Laksh. Tell me your answer. These students are keeping their mobiles and laptops on, but they are not responding. So Laksh Jairath, sorry, I'm also marking you absent. Ramanjeet, after Ramanjeet, Simran should be ready. Okay, Ramanjeet, you tell me this answer. Yes, Ramanjeet. Ramanjeet, am I audible to you? Ramanjeet, are you able to listen to me? So raise your hand whose answer is ready. Raise your hand whose answer is ready. Because in this answer you have to make a contrast of what is the reality and what does he want to become, what are his ambition. See, in reality he is doing a practice. He is an ordinary doctor. He is not earning a lot. He is living in a rented house and his house is having rats. There is no electricity. His condition is very much sad and pathetic. And whenever he gets a chance to look into the mirror, so what does he do? He starts thinking about his dreams. He starts appreciating about its beauty. So from this example, we can say that he is a great appreciator of beauty. Okay, and he wants to work upon his looks. He wants to look more handsome. And what are his desires? His desires are that. Someone is writing, my mic is muted. I'm not audible to you. My mic is on. There was some network problem. My mic is on, beta. You are not able to listen to me. Type in chat box. And my voice is audible to you? Yes. One student has written my mic is muted, but it is not muted. So in this way, you have to make a comparison between these two things. Okay. Now let's move to next question. Next question we have is, now read next question. Next question is, the person he wants to marry and the person he actually marries. Okay, which kind of girl he wants to marry? Tell me only first part of the answer, that which kind of girl he wants to marry. Dhiren, you tell me.
Ma'am, the homeopathic doctor wants to marry a girl who is fat and a girl who earns a lot from medical practice.
Yes, even more than him. Okay, very good. So here, he wanted to get married. A woman who earns a plenty of money, okay, but she should be fat also, with humor, with fun way it is added. She should be fat. Why so? Because if he commits any silly mistake, okay, and he wants to run, so that girl should not be able to catch him, okay. But actually the girl he marries, sorry, the girl he found, what was actually that girl? How was she looking? Can anybody tell me? However, the woman he actually married was thin. Another word for thin is slender. Who could run like a sprinter? Who could run like a racer? So this contrast between the kind of wife he wanted and the kind of wife he actually got adds to the humor to the story. Because whenever he desires, whenever he looks into the mirror, so he expresses his desire. What desire does he express? He expresses that he wants to get married to a fat girl. She should be affluent. She should be very much wealthy. She should earn a plenty of amount of money, a huge amount of money. She should be on medical practice. She should be in the same line. But actually, when he gets married and he gets married to a girl who is very much thin, and you can say she runs like a racer, like a sprinter. This word is given in your book. So you can copy this word from your literature book, sprinter. Okay? So this contrast also makes us laugh. His thoughts when he looks into the mirror, and his thoughts when the snake is coiled around his arm. Now these two comparison you have to make. Now you tell me only first part of the answer. His thoughts when he looks into the mirror. Pranay, you keep your video on. Then I will give you a chance to ask me query. I know Pranay is a fake ID. Pranay, if this ID is not fake, you keep it on. Keep your camera on. Otherwise, I'm going to remove you from my class, because you are interrupting a lot in between. One fake ID is there. Still they are. If your answer is right, if you know the answer, you should keep your camera on. How will I come to know that you are actual or you are fake ID? Okay, ninth A, Laksh. Keep your camera on for 1 minute. Okay, now you tell me this answer.
He thinks that he should look smart, so he decided to shave daily and retain his smile. He is happy and content when he looks into the mirror. Ma'am, second part bhi bolna hai na?
No, only first part. In first part, his thoughts when he looks into the mirror. Okay, so you can tell that he started appreciating all those lines I have spoken so many times. So you can repeat. Otherwise, Laksh, you have tried well. That's good. Now, Mitansh, you want to tell first part? When he looks into the mirror, what kind of thoughts was going in his mind? Try to speak.
When he looks into the mirror, he thinks that he should be look smarter than now, and he wanted to shave daily and comb his hair.
Or on looks, shave, mustache, such kind of things you can add.
He thinks that little mustaches should be on his face.
Thin mustache. Okay. So time is running out. Within 1-2 minutes, your class is going to get over. So we will continue this topic tomorrow. Okay. By the time you go through this text, find out the answers, and tomorrow you all should be enthusiastic. You all should be eager to tell me the answers. I don't want that my class should be passive listener. They should actively participate in my class. Okay, dear students, now thank you and have a nice day.